I'm Matt Harrington. I'm an EFCO Field Supervisor, and today's toolbox talk will revolve around cutting a REDI-RADIUS template. For this particular template that we're going to do, we're laying out for a 57'6" inside radius, and we're able to get both the inside and the outside radius laid out on this single 2x12. Step one is you have to lay out 12-inch increments on your 2x12. Last but not least, make sure you lay out your 12-foot mark, because the 2x12 is always longer than 12 foot. What this will do is give you a symmetrical board from one end to the other. Next step is to use a speed square and make your lines on your 2x12. On the build-up pages of the EFCO Erection drawings, we show all the different layouts in order to scribe our inside radius. And from there, what I like to do is go through and write by each line what the dimension is that we need to draw our line up to. And then from there, I go through, lay out the measurement with my tape measure, and then scribe the arc. Next step is to measure all of our dimensions and lay out our arc. So our first one is 6¾. At this point, our inside radius is laid out, and we'll go ahead, we'll do the same thing from reverse and lay out our outside radius from the other side. All right, now what we've been able to do is lay out both our inside and outside radius on a single 2x12, and this allows us to make use of the board as well as getting both radiuses cut and shaped at the same time. All right, in order to utilize our 2x12, what I like to do is lay out the dimensions so that way we have 2 or 3 inches of material in the middle of the board at the shallowest point. What that does is when the forms are set on the table, it keeps the 2x12 from wanting to break or crack, and that's what holds your form and allows it to take the shape of the given radius. At this point, you're ready to stand back and look at the radiuses that you marked out and double check them to make sure that your radius is nice and clean and has a good flow to it. Another good practice is to label your boards and your radiuses, and this one here is a 57'6". Inside radius. Outside radius. That way, if the boards need to be used again and you have more than one radius on your job site, you can keep your boards straight. All right, now we're ready to cut our radius. Usually a worm drive circular saw will cut any radius down to about 20 foot. Last of all, don't forget to cut your board to the 12-foot line. Cut the other board. Yeah, I slid my two radius boards together and they touch at the ends, and there's a little bit of a gap right here in the middle. We recommend laying out both the inside and the outside radius. That way your forms can follow the line and take a true shape of whatever your radius is. For really large radiuses, some people can get away using a single line cut for both the inside and the outside radius. But as you can tell, there is a slight discrepancy. So with the EFCO drawings, we do provide both radius lines, and it's pretty easy to cut both of them, as you can see. Cutting an EFCO REDI-RADIUS template is fairly easy. If you have any questions, by all means contact an EFCO Field Supervisor or look us up on the web on YouTube.